With this week's CMA Awards, we thought we'd give you an inside look into some of the incredible programs that are supported by the Country Music Association. Each year with the CMA Music Festival, the CMA donates half of the proceeds to the Metro Nashville schools to help keep the music playing. This year, the organization decided to donate the other half to flood relief to help those still recovering from the May floods. Kelly Lynn met up with Kix Brooks and Luke Bryan, along with lots of others, to talk about this year's donations.
I'm here with Karen from Little Big Town. Today's an exciting day. Talk a little bit about being able to present that check today for the flood victims and for music education for children.
Well, it's nice to be a very small part of that overall big picture, and our band has been, you know, a part of the CMA Festival for almost 10 years now, and to watch that happen is just truly amazing, and it speaks to this community, it speaks to country music and the fans and the power of coming together and really making a difference for some people.
This is probably the most money that you guys have had so far.
It has, and it brings our total from the Keep the Music Playing program from CMA to $4 million since 2006. It's incredible.
Now talk a little bit about some specific situations of where the money has gone.
We each year look to buy instruments across the board, really, in metro schools, elementary schools, middle schools, high schools. We're looking to build music education programs strategically as well as get them started. So we do both. And those programs are evaluated, and we want to make sure that we're using these resources to the best that we can and giving students many opportunities they would never have had before. Music is very important in this city, and it's important in our culture.
Both places where the money went, it's a big chunk of change. This isn't a drop in the bucket, you know. A lot of musical instruments will come from $1,400,000, and a lot of kids will have an opportunity to experience music that wouldn't have otherwise. It's really a big deal, and of course this year is unprecedented in terms of the flood in Nashville. And it's not generally what a trade organization does in terms of donating money to help people, but you know, our partnerships with the city here in a big way, especially with the music festival, which is where this music came from. We count on the city supports us, and it's only right that we give back when we have the opportunity.
For people out there watching in Middle Tennessee that need assistance, did they just contact you guys at the Community Foundation?
No, we don't give to individuals directly. We work with our partner organizations, nonprofit organizations, churches, and government agencies. If they want to know, if people who are listening to this want to know how to get access help, on our website, which is www.cfmt for Community Foundation Middle Tennessee.org, is a list of every single grant we have made, the organization to which we have made it, and what that grant was for. If people have a nonprofit or a church or a government agency and they are doing work with the flood, they are welcome to apply for a grant at that same website.
We can have a flood and have the biggest year ever at CMA Fest. So I think it was only right to give the money for flooding, and a lot of victims out there still living in probably a borrowed trailer or something. So, you know, the rebuilding process from the floods will continue for quite a while, and any little bit helps.
And thank all the fans for coming in this year. I mean, because they all still came to Nashville even after the tragedy.
Well, yeah, I mean, fans, essentially it's all the fans' money that make this happen, and it's just a testament to country music fans and just how great they are and how it makes me honored to have those fans out there. So it's a good day for us.
I'm now speaking for everybody in Nashville to the CMA. Thank you so much. This is fantastic. Thank you.
If you want to help support the CMA programs next year and hear some great live music, you can get your tickets to the 2011 CMA Music Festival June 9th through June 12th. Check out cmafest.com for more. Now, before we leave for today, we have our weekly songwriter tip brought to you by the Nashville Songwriters Association International. Here is James Dean Hicks to tell you why, as a songwriter, you always need to set your sights high.
Set your bar high when you try to write songs. If you listen to the radio, sometimes you'll hear songs, you go, well, that song's not very good, or that song didn't rhyme very well. and you start to ask yourself, ooh, how did that get on there? Well, if you research that song a little bit, you'll find it was either produced or written by maybe somebody that has something to do with the record. So it's kind of an inside cut. Do not lower your bar to get cuts. Raise your bar, because you got to beat out all the ones that have the inside track.
Check out NashvilleSongwriters.com for more information on NSAI. That's about all the time we have for today's show. Don't forget those new Smokey Robinson discs we have up for grabs from Cracker Barrel. If you want to enter this week's drawing for a copy of Now and Then, you have to email me your mailing address. That's Bailey@InsideMusicRow.com. Don't forget to check us out on Facebook, too, for all the latest news and events. We're going to leave you this week with Dierks Bentley and his hit, Up on the Ridge. Don't miss out next week when we hook up with Billy Currington. Until then, I'm Bailey for Inside Music Row, and I'll see you again real soon.
Hey now, honey child, we'd be running free and wild. No one care what you do, ain't no law to answer to. Dance around in the dirt, listen to them crickets chirp. Hear old Jake start to howl when he hears that old hoot owl. Give you all I got to give, that's how we live up on the ridge. Won't you come?